Have you been hearing about this hot new trend of platform engineering, but you're not really sure what the hype is all about? Or are you just tired of these blurred lines between platform engineering, DevOps, SRE, and all the rest? Well, in this video, we'll dive into the difference specifically between DevOps and platform engineering and explore why platform engineering may be the solution to your problems. Hi, I'm Luca from the platform engineering community. In this video, we're going to discuss the differences between DevOps and platform engineering and why platform engineering may be the solution to your cloud-native setup. So first of all, we need to start with a quick walk down the software engineering memory lane and look at how it all got started. When DevOps came up more than 10 years ago, the world was a very different place. We mainly developed monoliths, often running on bare metal. Our infrastructure was way less complex. There was no Kubernetes, no Terraform, no infinite CNCF landscape of tooling. And the initial idea behind DevOps was great. It was simply to remove the barriers between developers and operation teams and facilitate collaboration. The reality of DevOps today, however, morphed into something a lot less ideal. With the convergence of cloud-native technologies and trends like Kubernetes, infrastructure as code or IaC, GitOps, and pick your buzzwords du jour, the day-to-day of most developers has become incredibly complex. So let's say as an example that you want to deploy a simple change to your application and test it in a preview environment. Well, 10, 15 years ago, that would have probably meant touching a script and one or two tools. Today, that has exploded to multiple scripts, Helm charts, YAML files, Terraform modules, and a bunch of other cloud-native tooling you're just afraid of touching for fear of screwing things up. So this idea of you build it, you run it, in practice really just translates to developers being blocked and having to wait on operations teams to come to the rescue. And these ops teams are under increasing pressure and become a huge bottleneck to the org velocity. The situation often leads to ticket ops and DevOps burnout, undefined responsibilities, and in general, just a toxic relationship between developers and operations. And that is why platform engineering emerged, especially among leading tech companies and top performing organizations. They realized that they needed to build some sort of platform layer between developers and operations to enable developer self-service and ensure their setup could scale while also maintaining their governance and security standards. So platform engineering is the discipline of designing and building toolchains and workflows that enable self-service capabilities for engineering organizations operating in the cloud-native world. Platform teams build an internal developer platform, or IDP, which is a layer on top of the tech and tooling your team has in place already and binds them into golden paths that developers can follow to interact independently with the underlying infrastructure. They can self-serve environments, databases, and whatever they need to run their apps and services without having to wait on ops. Platform engineering therefore aims to fix broken and toxic relationships between developers and operations by enabling self-service for developers and allowing operations to focus on infrastructure challenges and not spinning up yet another environment. Several studies at this point have shown that internal developer platform usage highly correlates with higher DevOps evolution and performance. Gartner has recently named platform engineering as one of the top 10 strategic technology trends of 2023, predicting that by 2026, actually, 80% of software engineering organizations will establish platform teams as internal providers of reusable services, components, and tools for application delivery. Thanks for watching this video on the differences between DevOps and platform engineering. If you found this content valuable, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to stay updated on our latest insights and trends in platform engineering. And of course, smash that like button and ring the notification bell to never miss a video. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next one.